Hey, what's up guys, Tom1892 here of Retribution Gaming, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how you can do the Reaver King on Wingrave in just over 3 minutes melee. Going into the Wingrave build that I'm running for this, I have Divine Aegis maxed out, and with that, when we place that down, all Wayfinders are invulnerable, right? But you're also going to be building up stacks of Vengeance, increasing weapon power up to 10 seconds. We'll then also be running 1 point in Judgment, and this is just to deal additional break damage. It helps on the first phase, getting through that a little quicker, and when he's riding the bear, just breaking him so he comes off the bear quicker as well. For this, I put 3 pips into Radiant Pulse, mainly because I plan on playing with this build in group play, but you can also put your points into Righteous Strike, however, if you're more solo orientated. Just to show off my Wingrave stats, like it's not the most min-max kind of Wingrave yet, I'm still working on this, but it should give you a rough idea where you need to be aiming to achieve something like this in good time as well. So to begin with, you're going to start the fight normally, any spare momentum just dump at the start of the fight, then get out until the AoE is gone. Here then jump to you. For weapons such as Titan's Bane, you can start building up the momentum just by hitting thin air around the arena. You don't actually need to be hitting anything, you can just hit the thin air, build up full momentum, so when he jumps to you, it's full on, cast the weapon ability and straight into breaking him. And you basically then just want to break his bar, DPS him down as quick as possible, and then move on to the next phase. Now the bear will come along and revive him, here then hop onto the bear, and then basically all you want to do again, break the bar, DPS him down, quick as anything, pop some potions if need be, just get through this phase as quick as possible. So with this fight, it's not just a DPS race. In this fight, you also need to be positioned well, especially if you're melee. If you're standing in AoE trying to melee the boss, you're just going to take absolute crazy amounts of damage. You really do need to position yourself well in this fight, especially as melee. Once he jumps off the bear, you then want to start DPSing him and leave the bear alone, because these two need to ideally be killed together, right? So you're just going to start DPSing him down until he does his ability where he's just going to try and place the AoE down. Once he jumps off the bear, you then want to start DPSing him and leave the bear alone, because these two need to ideally be killed together, right? So you're just going to start DPSing him down until he does his ability where he's just going to try and place the AoE down. When that happens, you then want to use your skill number 4 to place down your invulnerable shield. From there, you want to be hitting the bear and Arturak at the same time to kill them both. They're both going to take very large amounts of damage off you. And as you can tell, I managed to clear this in 3 minutes 12. This is my fastest run yet, and I'm going to keep practicing this. It's still early days. I think you can get a little faster than this as well, for sure. But for those of you that are struggling with the fight, for those of you that are like running this at 7 minutes a clear and stuff, this is how you get it down to within that 3 kind of minute range, give or take. It just seems to be on this phase that both of them take massive amounts of damage, and then coupled with your buffs from the bubble and your potions, if you've still got any left, it's just crazy amounts of damage and they absolute melt. Overall though, this boss fight is really enjoyable, really liking how it works. Hopefully they make more like this as well going forward. Hopefully this video helps you. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. I'm Tom1892, and I'll catch you in the next video.